So, recently news have come up about Dan Houser, co-founder of Oster Games, about to be leaving the company. And yeah, with this document from Take-Two Interactive, the parent company of Oster Games, it's pretty much confirmed down here under other events that Dan Houser, vice president, creative at Oster Games, will be leaving the company. His last day will be on March 11, 2020, and that's just in over a month. This understandably has a lot of people worried. I remember back to when Leslie Benzies was kicked out of the company, was made to leave, and yeah, back then, from what I remember, he wasn't happy with where GTA Online in particular was going. Back then, I think it was the only really active franchise that Roster was actively working on and developing more content for. And yeah, since then, if it may be coincidental, if it may be more causality than causation. Back then, we had a lot of militarized vehicles, we had a lot of copy and paste DLC, where we were just repeating the same business structure over and over and over again. With a lot of vehicles just being overpowered, overweaponized, and of course, overpriced. And not even fitting the general theme of GTA Online, but being more futuristic and somewhat making the game feel less like GTA. I remember a lot of people having issues with stuff back in the day. And yeah, now we have another person in an executive position, heavily involved with the game's creation. With he was a co-founder of a company. He was heavily involved with a creative progress for a lot of the games. He really shaped the franchises and the company, the way it's being headed, for quite a few years. And overall, I get why people are worried about it. It's not something that you want to see happening, because this could really change how the entire franchise moves forward, how GTA moves forward, how other franchises maybe on the horizon turn out. And that's not an uncertainty people are happy with. However, in this particular case, I'm kind of happy to take a few chances here. Because from what I can tell, this whole thing about the weaponized vehicles and all, that was partially down to the Hauser brothers trying to monetize the game after Benzies was gone. I think that was pretty much what was happening there. And overall, one thing that really has me hopeful is the first part of a sentence. Because Dan Houser is not just leaving in a month. He was on an extended break since the beginning of Spring 2019. And what kind of DLCs have we seen come out of Roster Games since then? Because beforehand, as I mentioned, all the military stuff and all the overpriced things, and now 2019 was mainly the year of the casino. And overall, those DLCs, both the Casino and Resort DLC and the Casino Heist DLC, they were quite different from the DLCs beforehand. Not focusing so much on weaponized vehicles, but kinda going back to the roots a bit with some general crimes going on. Stuff like that. If we just look at the casino itself, which we have gotten in summer of 2019. While I did not really like the storyline itself, that was told with the six missions, I liked the little work we could do for Agatha Baker, and especially the casino itself here. I mean, we have a whole thing with a reel going on with a daily spin that we can just do for free. They have been giving out one vehicle a week. And sometimes really very expensive vehicles if you can spin it correctly for I don't know how many months now, and it's been one vehicle will cost over $1 million after the other. I don't know how expensive Oppressor Mark I is that's available now, but that thing definitely not under $1 million. We can quickly look it up here. Yeah, 2.65 millions. If you can hit it on the wheel with a 1 in 20 chance, you can just take it home and stuff like that. The way we have given away the vehicles, the free stuff you can get from the wheel, while it's not always amazing, it still needs to be recognized. The free armored vehicle that you can get at the end of the storyline and all, it would have usually taken a ton of money for this stuff, but suddenly this is all just being given away. The DLC itself did not have any weaponized vehicles apart from the armored one with the little pea shooters in front, which don't really do much, so in terms of that, the entire thing felt very different, and just with focus on some smaller missions and stuff like that, it felt more like a return to form for GTA, if anything else. And as I mentioned before, this is a DLC that came out after Danhauser took his break, but he was not really that involved in, as much as I can tell. Apart from maybe some of the stuff that happened in Veranda, but overall, this came out when he was already kinda gone. And then came the Casino Heist DLC, which, as many people say, is likely the best heist to ever be released in a GTA game, period. Because of how much you can do yourself, how many options you have, how many things you can determine yourself, and just how much sense everything makes. I did recently start playing GTA single player again, GTA 5, and honestly, a lot of the stuff doesn't even make sense. The characters are sometimes pretty obnoxious. I really just hated Michael's family after playing for the first parts until stuff happens, which I'm not gonna talk about. And yeah, honestly, this is more. It feels a bit better again, I gotta say, especially compared to the old DLCs with all the weaponized stuff. Which, the weaponized stuff isn't even much in this game right now. We haven't gotten much in terms of that. I'm gonna quickly go directly here again. Like, the Zaba is not weaponized, it's just a weird all-terrain vehicle with a lot of good armor, and this is something that we can definitely use in GTA Online. The JB is 700W, something that people have been asking for ages. Not overpriced, not really too heavily weaponized, mainly the mines or stuff that they can drop. The Invade and Persuade tank, definitely more of a heavily weaponized side. This is the only really weaponized vehicle that's gonna have an impact on the game. And imagine that this thing that costs over 2.2 millions was given away for free as a Christmas gift for anybody who logged in. So yeah, say what you want, but I think this thing is overall this is a different page for GTA Online compared to what has come out before, like the Scrambler with over 3 million, almost 3.5, with the Oppressor Mark II, which had like multiple paywalls in order to weaponize it, really, and change the weapons, get some upgrades on it, stuff like that. I think this is really this is a change of pace, and this all happened after Danhauser took his leave, so or took his break. So I don't know how much of an indication this is for things to come, but I'm rather hopeful that this will not be the worst thing to happen for GTA. Sometimes you may just need to switch out a few people because, yeah, things have gotten stale or gone into a particular direction that's not too desirable. And I think going into a direction that's not too desirable is a very, very fitting description for what happened to GTA Online over the past few years in general. So, yeah, anyway, that's gonna be it for this one. I just wanted to quickly go through the points and yeah, let me know what you think about this. If this was a good thing, if this was maybe, yeah, potentially just the worst thing that could happen. I mean, we will see what happens with the next games, but or the next DLCs for GTA Online. But so far, I'm rather hopeful. We will see how it really turns out once the next DLCs comes out. But yeah, till then, thanks for watching. Bye bye.